back here at the Keating Center. Antigonish, Nova Scotia, almost ready for puck drop here. Matt Cullen alongside Jamie Kelly. As mentioned before, a real, real big game for these two teams. Been two teams in very, very different positions. As we mentioned in the pregame, the X-Men just hanging on to that last place of the playoffs, sixth place. On the other hand, the Aigle Bleu, third place with a win tonight, that puts them in first. They're going to be ready to go. The X-Men, of course, they'll be showing a lot of fight as well. Look for a good game tonight.
Yeah, there's no easy games in this league, Matt. Absolutely not. You can't take anyone for granted. Moncton, absolutely. If they think they can come into this barn tonight and take St. Evex for granted, they'll have something coming to them. But I know that's not going to be the case. Their head coach is going to have them gunning off the first draw. Well, that obviously wins it back. But, I mean, these two teams, I'm really expecting a good game. They played both two times this season. Moncton won both times. Once 4-2, the other time 3-2 in overtime. So, I mean, they've been good games. 4-2 was in St. Evex at this building. Was one of the better games I've called. Moncton's a very fast, physical team. Watch their defense to punish X's forwards and get some back.
That's right. Opening puck draw there ends up in the Aigle Bleu zone. Puck tangled up, though, in the Aigle Bleu player's equipment, so we'll have a stoppage. Battle for along the boards. That's Ray keeping it in. He'll dump it in behind the net for Morrison, looking for Struthers in front. That pass misses him. And the Aigle Bleu will move to center. Puck dumped in there. And moved along the right side. Morrison will try and get it out. His weak pass does get through, and this is McAvoy moving through center. He'll dump the puck in. Struthers after Lacroix. Lacroix does a nice job moving the puck ahead. Quainel making moves in his own zone. And he'll move to center to Bergeron. He can't handle that pass, and the puck will come into the X-Men zone where Day takes it. Day, with a bit of time, will start out. He finds Stevens on the half boards. Stevens to center, and Brandon dumps that puck in. This is Marion behind his net. He scoops along the boards for Côté. Brandon gets there first, though. Puck kept in at the line there. Nice play by Mark Lewis. His shot hit an Aigle Bleu player and still down in the corner. That's Perrenteau there. Seems to be still limping, though, back in the play. The X-Member controller has a shot on net, and Marion makes a nice save. This is undershoot in the corner. Good shift here from the X-Men. This is Mark Lewis at the line. His shot stopped by Manuel. Undershoot, looking for that rebound. His shot goes through the crease. No one there. Comes out the other side. Big collisions there on the end boards. The Aigle Bleu will get the puck into the X-Men zone where Day takes it. Quick start for the X-Men. Just 2 minutes in here. They lead the shots 2-0. Both teams making changes. And Josh Day will have a bit of time behind his net. Pass getting in the center, deflected high off the glass. This is Fai takes it. He's with Blanchard. Fai can't get the puck to him, though, as Kirkpatrick does a nice job for the X-Men getting back. There's a pass in front, doesn't get through. The X-Men will move out, and here's Bass. Jason Bass to center. He dumps the puck in. Bryce Swan will chase it. Swan gets there, puts it in behind the net for Bass. His centering pass just missed Kirkpatrick. X-Men still have it as Pageau at the line. Dump back in behind the net for Kirkpatrick. Kirkpatrick working out. Another good shift here from the X. Centering pass, Bass in alone, and he hit the side of the net. Bass all alone in front, couldn't convert though. Bass still has the puck. The X-Men continuing the pressure. Centering pass, broken up nicely there by Fai.
It's a nice. Nope.
Puck dumped out. Will not go the distance for icing though, and the X-Men will take the puck and they'll start to move out. Page will get as far as Blanchard will let him. Blanchard a good job stopping that rush. Blanchard sticks with the play and dumps it back in, heads off on a change. Perricone sets it up for Chisholm behind his net. Chisholm moves to Ray. Ray, nice pass to Morrison in the middle. Morrison takes a shot. That shot wide comes. Oh, back the other side! And a shot there by Struthers and a nice save by Marion as he had to get across and make that save and he covers up.
Well, what a sequence there for the Blue and White. I mean, that's just phenomenal hockey by St. Evex. The first 3.5 minutes of this game, they have completely dominated. I mean, due to a solid forecheck, good shots on goal, and smart puck work on the boards. As we saw, I mean, slippery Jason Basket behind the defense almost had a great chance. Michael Kirkpatrick doing a lot of work down there. Bryce Swan doing work. Everyone's playing great so far, Blue and White. Real good start.
We'll see that line again as a quick shot by Kirkpatrick just swallowed up by Marion. We'll get another face-off.
And you know what? Go ahead.
Sorry, just about to say there, Coach Brad Peddle goes right back to the line that's been working.
Well, why not? And you know what? I mean, Bull Duke. As much as we say he's such a physical, mean guy on the back end, arguably one of the better hitters in this league with Chad Denny of UMB, he's a guy that also sometimes gets out of position with his pinches that he could get himself in trouble and lead to some offensive rushes for St. Evex. So that could be something to watch for.
We'll look for that there. Claffey with a shot. Rebound in front. Just squirts off to the side, and the Aigle Bleu with control. Pass to center. Comes outside the line. The X-Men were offside, though, so Stevens could not play that puck. Aigle Bleu behind their own net with Grew. Grew will make his way, and he finds Ouellette. Ouellette's pass intercepted by Stevens, and Brandon will make his way back in. Brandon going wide on his defenseman, Bolduc. He avoids him, still has the puck, finds Stevens on the side, tries to put it in front, undershoot there, finds Day at the point. Day to the other side, penalty upcoming for the Aigle Bleu as Perricone hustles at the bench. They have the extra attacker on now. And that pass deflected outside the zone, and the play will be called. And we'll have a hooking penalty, our first one of the game here. It'll go against the Aigle Bleu.
A little surprised how the ref blew the whistle there. Usually when the other team has that possession, not just touch it. So at that point, Ouellette didn't touch it. But anyways, he's off to the box, one of the best players. But this is huge. St. Evex drew that penalty from sheer hard work in the offensive zone. So hell of a job by them. And the number one power play in the league goes to work.
That's right. We mentioned the pregame special teams, a big factor. Kirkpatrick tries that shot, easily blocked there and sent out. It's McAvoy will take it in his own zone. 15:34 remaining in the first period. The X-Men outshooting the Aigle Bleu 5-0 so far. And on the power play, having some trouble getting set up, though, is good pressure from Rochon. The X-Men will try and break out again here, and Bass. He tries to dump it in, only gets so far. The puck does end up deep in the corner with Struthers. Struthers hammered to the boards there. Gets the puck to teammates, though. Back to Kirkpatrick. Kirkpatrick has the puck now. Kirkpatrick having trouble controlling it. Côté right on him, and Côté does a nice job sending him the length of the ice. And now him and Swan will mix it up after the whistle. No penalty called, though. 1 minute remaining in the X-Men power play. Having a little bit of trouble getting set up here. Is that number one power play in the league. Needs to connect if the X-Men are going to see some success. This is undershoot behind his net. Undershoot out on the half boards. Back up to Chisholm at the point. Chisholm over to Day. Day, his shot deflected out of play. And we'll get a whistle here. 40 seconds remaining in the Dean Ouellette penalty. 14:30 to go in the period.
It also just got a lot lighter in here. I don't know if the camera could see that. But one of the overhead lights was clearly out for the start of the game, and it just came on. You can see everything a ton better, so that's nice for vision for the players and for us.
Absolutely right there, yeah, in the U to M zone. A big difference. Marion plays that puck nicely up the boards to Fay. Fay, nice pass to Quinnell. Quinnell coming in shorthand. Quinnell puts the net, and Perricone got a pat on that. Good rush there by Quinnell. He still battles for it along the boards as the Aigle Bleu have done a fantastic job killing off this penalty.
That's a great hit.
Big hit there. That was Brandon on the boards. The X-Men counter. Here's Chisholm. Chisholm shoots and a nice save by Marion as he got the right pad on it. Bolduc behind his net as he goes hard off the glass and out. And that will pretty much do it for the X-Men power play. A great start to the game for the X-Men. A little bit uneventful on that power play, though, as maybe one or two shots, but that's about it. None of them that dangerous. Back to 5-on-5 hockey as Sims for the X-Men will dump it in. Marion does a nice job stopping it. He'll play the puck along the glass, looking for Ouellette, who finds it in his feet, moves the puck to center, and Pageau intercepts that. Pageau back in his own zone. Lacroix right on him, as well with Côté. Côté steals the puck, just momentarily. Puck right in the slot. The Aigle Bleu had a good chance there. This is Desvaux moving to center to Sims. Sims tips the puck in to the Aigle Bleu zone where Lacroix controls. Moves to Côté, and he'll send it in. Perrenteau in after it. Perrenteau circles the net. Stops up. Pageau defending him. Perrenteau from his knees now does a nice job getting the puck. And a shot by Rochon was stopped by Perricone. Puck chipped along the board. Sims is able to chip it out, and that will go the length of the ice for an icing call.
Yeah, that's a good change there for St. Evex, but good job by that fourth line. Sims, DeVoe, and obviously you got, for Z back there. So good, real good shift by them. I mean, that's a line that's not going to get a whole lot of ice, but when they're on, they have to make everything of the opportunity. They really have to show the coach that they can potentially get more ice time. So good first shift by them. They're just known to be a physical line. Chip in the odd goal very rarely, but I mean, they're heart and soul of the team. So
and a bit of confusion here with the lines. It looked like that line will have to stay out due to the icing call.
Yeah.
So So the Aigle Bleu looking to take advantage here with a tired St. FX fourth line. Desvaux will come in to take the draw against Fay. Desvaux does a nice job of winning it. Puck shot around in the X-Men zone. And the X-Men will get it out to center, and they will get a change. Gruel in his own zone. Moves over to Bolduc. Chips it through center. Nice job. Intercepted by Bass. He breaks in. Shot and a glove save by Merritt. Rebound in front. That puck doesn't quite get through as that was blocked. The puck sent out of play into the stands. Good rush there by Bass as he was able to get a quality shot off.
In any league, Matt, turnovers are caused by pressure. Right there. Bryce Swan hard on his man. It looked like Gruel gave a pizza sauce like an easy bake oven right up the middle to Bass. I mean, he just had all the time in the world to pick that off. Bass, not the guy you want to turn the puck over to, gets a real quick shot in the high slot. So good job by X applying lots of pressure.
He does. Unfortunate for the Aigle Bleu that rebound wasn't able to get put on net as well, as there was a big one off at the glove of Marion there. We move our way along in the first period. 12:20 now remaining. Shot 7-1 X-Men as they're off to a quick start. And they're at it again here as Kirkpatrick in, looking for Bast on the side. Bast spotted by his man. Still a battle for it along the boards there. Swan in there. Puck comes to Bass, who finds Claffey at the point. Claffey controls, puts the puck towards that. Block there and shovel to the corner. Swan will go after Lacroix. Swan still with it. Finds Bass in behind that. His centering pass. No one there. X-Men trying to make a change here, and that's why that puck will come out there as the defense were trying to make a change. O'Connor controls for the X-Men, and he'll dump that puck right back in. Marion sets it up for Labrie there. Labrie will control as the X-Men will complete their change. Now they'll start out. Still waiting the game's first goal here as the Aigle Bleu dump it in where McAvoy controls. He takes a hit, stays on his feet though, and keeps the puck. Undershoot. Avoids his man and makes a nice pass through center, one which Brandon could not control though. Brandon does hustle onto it. Loses it though, and the Aigle Bleu will take over. They will break out only as far as center, though, where McAvoy will turn them back. Undershoot tags up and will pursue in the Aigle Bleu zone. This is Gay behind his net. Does a nice job of giving it.
There is a
big hit there by Charlon. That was by Struthers, and he'll get a penalty as he took a big hit out of Doug Peace out of Charlon. And he's going to get a penalty for it.
Yeah, you know what? I sincerely disagree with this call. Absolutely disagree with this. Jared Struthers has been a guy that's been penalized a lot this year. Has taken a lot of dumb penalties, but this one, excellent hit. Textbook body check. May have been a little bit away from the boards. Doesn't matter. It was shoulder right to the shoulder, a lip a little from the side. But to me, that's a nice hit. Clean hit. He had the puck. I'm disappointed with the call there, and especially with the elbow. I mean, if anything, it may have been a boarding, but I don't see any elbows flying up. So hopefully X can kill this penalty, because that is a very unjust penalty. And there we go. Jason Bast
in one-on-one now. His shot from the outside. Blocked away easily by Marion. Bast will find Kirkpatrick behind the net. Looking in front. Bast in front. Backhand. And a glove save by Marion. A nice one, too. As the X-Men looking for their first shorthanded goal of the year. That elusive shorthanded goal that they haven't found this year. Back to that penalty there as Struthers. A big impact there on Charlon, and Charlon didn't like it, and they were talking after, and we'll see if that comes up later on in the game, as I know that Charlon didn't appreciate that. His team on the power play, though, for another minute and 40 seconds, and now they'll start out. This is Lacroix to center. He'll dump it in the other corner. Pageau hustling there. He'll go off the boards, gets as far as the line, then will Gruel keep it in. The X-Men will get the puck out, though. That sent the end of the length of the ice by Pageau. Marion. Play, nice pass up there to Bergeron. Bergeron looking for Quenel. Quenel, nice move around Claffey. Puts the puck into Bergeron. Ouellette taking the puck as Claffey and Bergeron there were tangled up behind the play. No harm done, though. X-Men do get the puck out. Just over the midway mark here of the first period. Still no score between the Aigle Bleu and the X-Men. Perrantot will now have it behind his net. They look to set up. He finds Dean Ouellette on the other side. Ouellette on the half boards, and now they will set up. Back to the point. This pass over to Gruel. Gruel looking for Quenel. Quenel starts to move towards the net. Fakes the shot. Finds Ouellette in the corner. He will come out to the half-boards. Nothing for him there, though. X-Men doing a good job cutting off the pass. There's a pass there that's blocked by Mark Lewis. Puck will get to the point. Gruel will keep it in. This is Ouellette on the boards. To Quenel. Back to Ouellette. Centering pass. His
there
shot. Lacroix looking for the one-timer fan, though, and the X-Men catch a break there. As that would look like a dangerous chance. They will get the puck out here, though, and get a change. 10 seconds remaining in the Struthers penalty.
Well, yeah, we mentioned it there earlier in the pregame, how Ouellette always goes to Lacroix on the power play for the big one-timer. He tried it right there. Lacroix couldn't cash in, though.
Back to 5-on-5 here as Struthers out of the box. So both teams 0-for-1 on the power play. This is O'Connor in his own zone, pressured by Fight. Moves it over to McAvoy, though, who moves up to Ray. Ray bump, doesn't get the puck out. Côté keeps it in. This will be Fai on the boards, battling with O'Connor. Shovels down to Perrantau and McAvoy. McAvoy tries to move it, cut off by Côté. And Côté sends the puck in front, looking for Fai. He couldn't find it. Jodin at the point. His shot, gloved by Perrantau. And there'll be a whistle with 8:20 remaining in this first period.
Yeah, a little bit of animosity between the two teams. I mean, these guys don't play each other a whole lot. This is only their third time so far this season. X has played a lot of other teams four times. But that not just this week, but next week, it's going to be the old Moncton-St. Thomas doubleheader. So this week it's Moncton-St. Thomas in Antigonish. Next week in Antigonish leaves and plays Moncton in Moncton Friday night and then St. Thomas next Saturday in Fredericton. Or Fredericton.
X-Men controlling in their own zone there. Chisholm moving to Pajot, who moves it out nicely to Brandon. Brandon, 3-on-3 there as the Aigle Bleu have a nice do a nice job getting back, and they're able to tip that puck out of play.
You know, this line of undershoot Stevens and Brandon has been rewarded the whole night. I mean, they're easily the top line so far for St. of X in this game. This is about their fourth shift, and we're only about 12 minutes in. So I mean, they're having a really good game, and they're a line that mostly they're there for grittiness, drive the boards, dump it in. Create space for, a guy like Stevens because he can put the puck in the net, as can undershoot. But, I mean, they're not basically known for offense, but they can chip in too. They're a line that can do it all. They're very balanced.
We'll see how that plays out here, but it will be the Aigle Bleu breaking out 2-on-2. This is Rochon. His shot off a leg goes to the other corner. And undershoot will take over. He skates through center. Finds Brandon. And now they'll enter the zone. Brandon a shot wide. Undershoot hustles to get to it. He puts the puck towards that, steered away by Marion. Stevens will battle for it on the boards and wins it. He keeps the puck and finds Brandon as they cycle in behind the net. Undershoot with it now. Tugged at, looks at the ref. No call, though. Puck chipped to the boards. McAvoy will keep it in, though, just momentarily, as that puck will squeak out. And Claffey will take it there. He gives it up to Perrantau, though. And the Aigle Bleu will control. This is Rochon with speed through center. Rochon with a shot and then a nice save by Perrantau. Puck chipped out where Dean Ouellette will control. Puck moved over to Bolduc. This is Gruel takes a hit as he moves the puck out. And Ouellette dumps that puck in. Aigle Bleu will complete a change here. 6:47 remaining in the first period. Still no score. X-Men are outshooting the Aigle Bleu 10-3, but have nothing to show for it so far. This is Kirkpatrick. Tries to make a move. Gets the puck, gets to the net, and knocked away there by an Aigle Bleu defender. Puck to the line. Lewis with a shot. Deflected. Stopped by Mario. Oh. And just missed on the far side as that was Bast. As that puck was loose at the far side. The Aigle Bleu will come away with it, though, looking for a 2-on-1 if they hurry. This is Gru looking in front. And that pass missed his target. Bast quickly back the other way for the X-Men as the pace picks up. Bast drops for Swan. Swan fires. And that play was broken up nicely there by Gru. The Aigle Bleu will now counter. Puck put towards the net. And Lacroix controls. Lacroix puts the puck towards the net. Broken up there by Lewis. Lewis tries to elude his defender. Bergeron can't do it. Lewis does a nice job of taking that puck back, though. Only momentarily, though, as the Aigle Bleu come in with a shot. And that's stopped by Perrantau. Perrantau still down. Puck centered towards the net. Aigle Bleu move their way down with Lacroix, who has trouble handling that pass. And the X-Men will take over. This will be Ray to center. Ray cutting in wide on Labrie.
Good job.
Puts the puck towards that good speed by Ray there as he was able to get around his man. This is Blanchard for the Aigle Bleu. He will try and go wide. His shot tipped wide by O'Connor of the X-Men. Puck centered in front, and Struthers will...
Oh!
Struthers couldn't get it out there, and that shot towards the net. Perricone had trouble with it. Goes off his shoulder and high. Chisholm on the puck. Can't get the puck out, though. Will try a second time and does. Morrison battling with Gay. Puck moved over to Blanchard. He slips and falls. Gets back up, though. Finds Jodin on the far side. His sharp angle shot will be swallowed up by Perricone, and we'll have another whistle. 4:52 now remaining in the first period. Still no score.
Real solid end-to-end action here, Matt. I mean, there's three on twos every 30 seconds here. I mean, it's exciting to watch for the fans, obviously. Might not be so exciting for the coaches. I'm sure they're a little nerve-wracked over there. But, you know, it's both goalies standing tall. Perricone seeing a few real good shots, as is Marion. It's been real solid in that so far. So both goalies up to the task as to date.
You're absolutely right there, Jamie. The X-Men will move to center. That puck tipped in right on by Marion, who gloves it and plays the puck very well. Marion, a goalie who likes to play the puck here, as we see in the early going. Very helpful for his defenseman.
Oh,
nice
boy.
Play there by Fye to get that puck through center to Blanchard. Blanchard looking for Fye. Puck goes off a skate, though, and the X-Men will come back. Undershoot with a bit of space on the far side. Undershoot coming in. His shot blocked there by the defender. Undershoot will move the puck back over. And a shot from the line will be shot.
Wow.
And a rebound in front. Knocked away. Shot from the point. A couple nice saves there from Marion. Bolduc does a nice job getting the puck to center to Blanchard. And they will get the puck in. X-Men controlling their own zone as Ray moving to center. Ray trying to chip it past his man. Eventually does. And DeVoe, puts that puck in. Sims on the boards. Falls down, and the Aigle Bleu will come away with it. This is Côté through center. Côté in, looking for Rochon in,
wow.
And a nice save by Perricone. He's able to get
the
right leg on, excuse me. Nice rush there, and a nice move by Rochon, but Perricone up to the task. DeVoe in on the boards. Battling there, the Aigle Bleu will come away with the puck. It's Rochon again with Côté, 2-on-2 this time. Nice pass back to Côté. Côté in around the net, still has the puck. Good puck control here by the Aigle Bleu. Puck dumped in there, Ouellette lets it go. Puck back to the point, this is Labrie controlling. His pass goes outside the line for Lacroix. X will try and make a quick change here. And they are able to, as the Aigle Bleu can't get the puck back in the zone. Day moves the center to Lewis. Kirkpatrick does a nice job hitting to Swan. Swan just a step ahead of the play, though, and called on the offside. 2:41 remaining now in the first period. Still no score.
This X-Men Hockey webcast is brought to you by the X-Varsity Club. Join the teams behind the teams. The X-Varsity Club is the fundraising entity for the St. of X Athletic Program. Your financial support is essential to our success in maintaining the tradition of excellence. Visit www.goxgo.ca to learn more about the X-Varsity Club or to join today.
Puck face off one there by the Aigle Bleu. Puck comes back into their own zone as Bergeron tries to chip it to center. The X-Men will send them back, though. Here's a chance here on the far side, as that was Quinnell who was taken down. No call, though.
Yeah, that's a good no call, too.
And now there's a little bit of rough stuff here after the whistle, as I don't think Quinnell liked the way he was taken down there. Some frustration showing.
Yeah, there's frustrations down there, but I think Quainell, and we couldn't really get a read on who the other guy was in there, but I think they ought to be careful because I don't know who they're messing with. Number 25, Mark Lewis, 6'4", 225 pounds, big Western boy, doesn't take any liberties. He would dummy probably anybody on the Moncton team, so I'd be a little cautious if I were them, and I believe it is...
Bergeron there is...
Yeah, and he's not too small of a guy either, but Lewis is probably the toughest guy in this league. Before games, when players are doing the hacky sack, stretching, not Mark Lewis. Mark Lewis is in the hallway boxing. So he's a guy, I'm telling you, you don't want to mess with. He's huge, menacing, but that's not the story of him off the ice. He's an exceptional guy off the ice, real gentle giant, but on the ice, I wouldn't mess with him.
And it looks like the Aigle Bleu are going to go to the power play there as the referees choose one, and it will be Claffey of the X-Men who will sit for two or less. Coach Brad Pettle, the X-Men, not happy with that call, discussing it over with the officials. The call will stand, though.
Well, you're right. It's a bit surprising. There's four guys in there, two X-Men, two Moncton players. So to see one X-Men go, it's a little surprising, but that's the way it is. And got to move on. Big kill here coming up for St. Evex.
And it starts off well as Bass dumps the puck, and Marion controls there, pushes it around the net for Labrie. He will control. He'll chip the puck up to center as Faye comes in. Day had him lined up, though, and does a nice job breaking that up. Puck sent back in. Aigle Bleu 0-for-1 on the power play so far. 1:55 here remaining in the first period. 1:30 to go in the penalty. Here's a chance for Kirkpatrick of the X-Men. Kirkpatrick breaking in a partial break. Shoots, and that's stopped by Marion. He will be forced to cover up. It's Pageau right there.
No, right there, Matt. Kirkpatrick, it looked like he had a good odd man rush there, a good breakaway coming up. But the puck, he just couldn't find it on him. It was kind of lagging with him in his skates a bit, so he couldn't really get a quality chance off, and Marion saw that the whole way. So as it did look like a good quality scoring chance, a potential for St. Evex to get their first shorthanded goal ends up turning into not too much of a chance.
So. Yeah, you're absolutely right there, Jamie. It looked like that puck skipped on him a little bit at the very end there. Nonetheless, able to get a decent shot off, but Marion up to the task because he has been with all 12 shots pointed his way so far. Here's a chance now, and a shot blocked by the X-Men. Lacroix trying to stay with it, though. Puck will come to O'Connor on the boards, and he will send the Aigle Bleu back with it. Under a minute to go in the Struthers penalty. This is Gruel through center. Finds Ouellette and Bergeron. Puck jammed up, and here's a chance again. Brandon shoots, and he puts it high. Bass on the boards looking in front, and he hits the side of the net. Tough break there for Brandon, as that's a couple partial breaks that the X-Men have had. Unable to convert, though. Moving to the last minute of the first period. This is Bergeron cutting wide, looking for teammates. Finds Gay at the point, having trouble. Here's a chance again. Bass trying to get around, and Gay takes the penalty there as Bass had him beat. And maybe if there's such thing, Jamie, as a smart penalty, that would probably be one of them.
That's it. That's an awesome. You're right. That was a smart penalty on the Moncton side. But we cannot discount the exceptional speed and work ethic of Jason Bass. I mean, he's one of their skill guys, and he's showing a lot of jam right now. Hell of a job by him. Exceptionally impressed so far with St. Evex's penalty killing. Haven't seen it this good this season. I mean, they've probably killed about 3 penalties so far, and all their kills have been very aggressive. They're getting quality scoring chances, and if they kill this way the whole season, they might be leading the league in shorthanded goals, but it's not been that way.
That's right. Looking very dangerous on the shorthanded. St. Evex only killing off 81% of their penalties. That has to be in the bottom half of the league. The Aigle Bleu 0-for-2 on the power play, though.
I mean, yeah, you're right. And this is not a penalty kill that Moncton is used to seeing from St. Evex, at least. I'm sure they did not have this in their game plan. But St. Evex has changed a bit in their penalty killing routine, and it's really certainly made an effort.
4-on-4 now as McAvoy tries a shot. Underneath fans there, though. And here's a chance for the Aigle Bleu. Rochon Faye, and Rochon has some trouble controlling that puck. And some little bit of rough stuff away from the whistle there. Claffey now back on the ice, though, as the X-Men will enjoy a short power play. 15 seconds remaining, though. As, again, the rough stuff away from the whistle continues. These teams do not like each other. Morrison takes a run at his man, misses, though. And now a big hit there on the side. And the period will come to an end there as Bolduc fans on his shot. And an eventful one, Jamie, filled with a little rough stuff there at the end. The X-Men will start the second period on the power play, though, but no scoring in that first period. The X-Men do lead in shots 12-7. They got off to a very fast start there, outshooting the Aigle Bleu 7-1 there at one point.
Yeah, you know what, for the most part, that was St. Evex's period. They definitely won that. I was shooting the Aigle Bleu 12-7 currently. I'm sure you'd agree with me and the viewers would agree. St. Evex, for the most part, was all over them there. Did take a few penalties, but the penalty kill was up to the task. Joey Periconi's been strong. On the other end, Marion has been really good for Moncton, so good job by both teams. Good period.
That's right. As we mentioned before, no scoring, 0-0 after one. The X-Men 0-for-1 on the power play. They will continue that, though, as the second period starts. The Aigle Bleu 0-for-2. And, Jamie, will we have a chance for an intermission interview here?
Yes, we do. We're going to have an interview at the 8-minute mark with assistant coach Aaron King for the X-Men, so we'll get him there. And so stay tuned another 8 minutes or so, and we'll have that for you.
And welcome back to the Keating Center here in Antigonish. No score between the University of Moncton Aigle Bleu and the St. Francis Xavier X-Men. Here now with Jamie Kelly is down on the with the bench with St. FX coach Aaron Keyes. Let's throw it down to him. Go ahead.
All right, I'm Jamie Kelly here, joined with SSN. We're live here tonight in Antigonish, Nova Scotia, Friday, January 27th, with my favorite guest, assistant coach Aaron King of the St. FX X-Men. You know what? It's 0-0. You guys are 12-7 in shots so far. You're penalty killing. You haven't scored a shorthanded goal this season, but tonight you guys are exceptional, creating a lot of chances on the penalty kill. What are your thoughts on that?
Yeah, we don't try to go out on the PK and try to get a goal. This is a very skilled team and very dangerous. Our first and foremost responsibility is to keep them on the outside and not give up the grade A chances. But, you know, we've got a lot of skill and speed of our own. And if we can create some chances like we did in the first off the PK, shorthanded goal is a big energy boost for any team.
Absolutely, is it ever. Also, their defense, big and mean, but you guys have done a great job so far of playing physical on them and creating a lot of turnovers for them based on your strong forechecking. Is that in the game plan tonight? Or?
Yeah, their defense is a big group, and it's a very physical group. So we want to get the puck deep on them and kind of play their game a little bit as well. We want to hit them hard and hopefully wear them down a little bit that we can create some chances, not only early in the game, but maybe later a couple of chances will open up for us.
And lastly, you guys this season, which is almost unheard of, have lost 11 one-goal games, which are so close. You win five of those during the upper echelon of the season. How important is leadership in a one-goal game? And it's 0-0 right now, so this could be another one-goal game. I know you got guys like Bryce Swan, Brett Morrison, guys who've been there before. How heavily are you leaning on them in these tight checking games?
Well, these guys, our leaders are unbelievable. On the ice and off the ice, we got a lot of leadership and a lot of veteran guys in our room. So we lean on those guys pretty hard. But our group, even the rookies, you know, like you said, we've been in 11 one-goal games. We're comfortable now in those one-goal games. All we're doing now is we're looking to change the tide a little bit. And maybe instead of losing those one-goal games, we'll be up one goal with the buzzer going. So hopefully we can get that going instead of going the other way.
Perfect. That was Aaron King, assistant coach of the St. FX X-Men. We'll bring it back up to you, Matt, at SSN.
Thank you very much, Jamie. Jamie there, as he said, there with X-Men assistant coach Aaron King. There's about 4.5 minutes till the second period starts. Stay tuned. The second period puck drop is next. Welcome back, everyone, to the Keating Center in Antigonish, Nova Scotia. No score between the University of Moncton Aigle Bleu and the St. Francis Xavier X-Men. Matt Cullen back here with Jamie Kelly, ready for second period puck drop, or almost anyway, and a fast-paced first period between these two teams, one where the X-Men outshot the Aigle Bleu 12-7, although good chances on both ends, both Marion and Perricone up to the task on both ends. And a little bit of rough stuff at the end there, Jamie.
Yeah, a little bit of rough stuff for sure. I mean, there's lots of animosity between these two teams. Talking to assistant coach Aaron King at intermission, he explained to me, like some of the viewers saw, that how good of a pace this first period had, and that how important it is for his team and their leaders to show a lot of emotion and compassion their last 40 minutes here, so they don't lose their 12th straight one-goal game, potentially. Not straight, but 12th.
That's right. Obviously, a key stat there. And important to note here, X-Men start the period on their second power play, 50 seconds remaining in that. Is the Aigle Bleu doing a good job killing it off? That's Dean Ouellette battling with four X-Men in the corner. Good job by him. The X-Men do finally come away with it, though, as Bass moves to center with Struthers. Struthers in on the right side.
Whoa!
Shot! And off the goalpost there. It looked from here. It might have been in, but the referee right there waves it off. Power play continues with Bass on the boards. He is with Struthers. As now Brandon comes in, the X-Men will come away with it. They continue to cycle on the boards. Brandon picks it up. 12 seconds remaining in the power play. McAvoy at the line. Moves over. That was Kirkpatrick. Back to McAvoy. Fakes the shot. Back to Bast. Bast on the hash mark. Cuts towards the net. Down to Struthers. Penalties over. Gay is back on. There's a shot in front. Stopped by Marion. He covers up. It's good pressure there. From the X-Men is now Bolduc, not having any of Bass being in front of the net, and gets takes care of him. Couple great chances, including a post there, Jamie.
Very good chances there. Excellent, smart power play by X. They didn't rush the play. They weren't looking for the big time shot. No one was being selfish out there. Everyone was using each other. They made the passing lanes open up with their exceptional dominance by their stick handling there. And Jared Struthers at the crossbar. It looked to us that it could have gone in.
It did. It did from up here. That puck looked like it, but that referee standing there waving it off.
It's too hard to tell. I mean, there's no video
replay.
You're
absolutely right.
We could be wrong. You never know.
You're absolutely right. It was waved off, so we remain at 0-0 undershoot. Controlling at center. Passes to Swan, who dumps it in. Marion will come out of the net, makes a nice play, and gets that puck out. Day will have to hustle back. Day being pressured by Bergeron, who will now back off, and the X-Men will control, and they'll start a breakout. They come through center and dump the puck on. Undershoot has a chance here in front, knocked away nicely there by the Aigle Bleu defender. This is Ouellette at center. Ouellette gets around his man, and Bergeron will continue after it. Bergeron down to Ouellette on the boards. That's Quesnel fighting for it. Puck pushed along the boards to Labrie, who keeps it in. X-Men do control, though, and they will move up to center with Pageau. Pageau moving in, making moves on his defender, Lacroix, who deals with it nicely and breaks that play up. Puck chip to center, who Ouellette controls. And this is Quesnel in on the left side. Quesnel, his shot high and wide. Puck comes to Claffey on the boards, who controls. Finds Stevens. Puck goes off his skate and kept in there by Jodin. Claffey now in his own end. Uses the glass to get the puck out to Stevens. Stevens one-on-two. He'll wait for teammates, and he has Brandon trying to make a move, and that puck poked away at the last minute. 17-15 remaining in the second period, which is still await this game's first goal. Puck on the end boards in the St. FX zone. Brandon battling with it with Charlon. Blanchard comes away with it, and he finds Faye on the end boards. Faye looking at the point, has Gay, loads up, shot just wide. There's a good hard low shot there from Gay. Stevens battling with Faye on the boards. Puck comes to the middle, and that's Pageau controlling. Ray controls there, and now they'll finally get it to center. Stevens over to Mark Lewis, his shot. Fooled Marion, he just got a pad on it. That handcuffed him a little bit. No harm done, though, as the puck goes to the corner. Now the Aigle Bleu will come out. This is Fay. Dumping that puck in. Chisholm right there. Puck moved to center there. Swan does a nice job getting a stick on that to negate an icing call. Kirkpatrick, good hustle. He frees it up for Swan. Looking for Kirkpatrick. In behind the net, Kirkpatrick. Over to Bass. Back to the point. Here's O'Connor. Has a little bit of trouble with it. Keeps it onside, though. Kirkpatrick. Swan hustling in after that. Puck comes behind the net to Kirkpatrick. Hits the referee. And the Aigle Bleu will control. And they will get it to the line. And now they won't get it out. As Kirkpatrick controls. They had a good chance to get that puck out there. Couldn't do it. Swan controls on the boards. As that's Gruel in the net there. Able to pick himself up and get out of there. Puck centered in front. And Swan. And a nice save by Marion. As he was able to get that pad on it. There's a shot. And a glove save. And Marion will hang on. And Bolduc having absolutely none of that.
Yeah, wow.
As he takes Bryce Swan right to the end boards. And that's the second time they've done that. And we've seen the referees take one before. And they might take Bolduc here.
Yeah, I think they're taking Bolduc here. And well-deserved. I mean, Bolduc went after him. Great job by Bryce Swan by not retaliating, keeping his composure, and just letting Bolduc do the dirty work on him. But you know what? Bryce Swan, one of his better shifts I've seen this game all season. He was an absolute maniac down there. He had two huge hits in the corner. Really good chance, just missed. All in all, an excellent shift there by that line of Kirkpatrick, Swan, and I believe it was Bass. So real good job. And, I mean, they keep playing like this. It's the style of hockey that we haven't seen so much of St. Evex this season. But you really do see the potential when they play like this, that they can really play with other
teams.
There.
They did a great job pressuring the Aigle Bleu defenders there. They caused a few turnovers, like you said before, and A-League turnovers are going to lead to chances. And Bass with Swan had a great one, although the St. FX penalty here will be short-lived, I believe. Yes, now the whistle blows. It looks like we might have a high sticking call here. The referee will look on Labrie for any blood. Looks like we'll have a two-minute call, and that'll be it for the X-Men power play.
Yeah, that is it for the X-Men power play. Accidental high stick there by Scotty Brannon. What can you do? Just got to move on. We got 4-on-4 hockey. Very dangerous to point out. It looks like Moncton will have Willette and Fahey as the forwards. Or no, Fahey just goes off. But
Quayle will be on there.
Yeah, they're two both really dangerous guys. Especially in 4-on-4 with a lot of ice, you got to be careful. If they're going to pinch, if they got guys that will pinch, like Pageau and Day, you have to have one man back to cover Willette.
So we'll play 4-on-4 for the next minute and 24, and the Aigle Bleu will then enjoy a short power play. This is Pageau to center with Struthers. Pageau stops up, puts it in for Struthers. Struthers takes a bump, keeps on it though. Ray in there cycling forward as well. Finds Struthers and back to Ray. Quick passing from the X-Men. They free it up. This is Pageau on the right point. Pageau puts the puck in for Struthers, looking for Day at the point. He couldn't handle the pass, though, and it comes out to center. X-Men controlling in their own zone. Pageau will dump the puck in from center. Marion, as he does so often, out to stop the puck, and he'll play it along the boards to Jodin, who makes a move. The Aigle Bleu can't get it out, though. There's a shot by Claffey, tried to get it away. Good play there by Quainel to break that play up. There's a turnover. There's a big hit by Quainel on the board. Centering by, here's Bass, looking for teammates, and that's Kirkpatrick, who would have had an open net, although it goes off the skate of Labrie there. Golden opportunity for the X-Men, just getting away. This is Jodin in his own zone. Still 4-on-4 here, 13:47 remaining in this second period. No score between these two teams, and a good game so far. This is Jodin, flips the puck in, and Bolduc standing in the box waiting to come on. As he does so now, the Aigle Bleu will go on their third power play, and here's a chance as Perrenceau has it, looking for Bolduc. Bolduc crashing the net. There's a nice save by Perrenceau, and he's able to hang on.
Big save by Perrenceau there, but again, as I've mentioned so much in this game so far, St. Evex is just doing a tremendous job on the big, mean defense of Moncton. Moncton is panicking. Their defense behind their net do not know what to do with the puck because they always see two blue and white sweaters right ahead of them. The forecheck, the 2-on-1, is going tremendous for them. One guy in the puck, one guy in the body, one guy in the puck, then one guy in the slot is working really good for St. Evex so far, so I wouldn't change that up if I'm Brad Peddle.
Short power play here for the Aigle Bleu as a shot flips towards the net. Perrenceau can't find it. Claffey is checked on the end boards and Perrenceau will control. Passes back to Gruel. Brandon's out of the box. We're back to 5-on-5. Shot blocked there by Struthers. And he's looking for Brandon, who just misses the pass. Pass going for icing. And unfortunate as Brandon was there first. But the no-touch icing will be called, and we'll have a face-off back in the X-Men zone.
Yeah, it's unfortunate. Scotty Brandon almost got his second breakaway of the game there. That was very close. So what can you do? Just got to move on. But again, good kill. It wasn't long, but St. Evex got it done. Now we're back to 5-5.
We mentioned special teams, a big part of both teams' game. Both teams 0-3 so far on the power play. Ray moving to center, dumps the puck in there. Poulin takes down Struthers in the middle. No call there. That's Brandon taking a run at his man. Puck in on the end boards. Brandon will pick it up, and he'll try and move to center. Chips to the line as he was fortunate that Lacroix was moving back there, and that puck does get to center. This is Rodrigue, and he makes a few extra moves to the side, putting teammate Poulin offside. And while we have a quick moment here, we'd like to say that this X-Men hockey webcast is coming to you live on SSN Canada, the streaming sports network. Visit the streaming sports network at www.ssncanada.ca. SSN, your sports, anywhere, anytime. Face-off just outside the X-Men zone, won by Kirkpatrick. And they will move to center. Swan has that puck go by him in the end zone. Puck flipped back out to center, and this is Lewis. Puck lost in the center as Ouellette tips that puck in. Perricone will be forced to hang on. And we have just one more moment here. We'd like to say that feel free to send us any feedback on this broadcast. We welcome any comments or messages. We can receive your emails at the following address. So if you have your pens ready, stfx.webcast@gmail.com. Of course, any pronunciations that we might be mistaking.
Bogus.
And we're going to have a penalty here coming up. As Marion hustles to the bench, they have the extra attacker as Bolduken on the end boards. Puck centered towards the net, still loose, controlled by the Aigle Bleu. This is Faye at his line. Faye shoots, puck towards the end, tipped in front just wide. And now the X-Men will gain control. And we'll be going back. And the Aigle Bleu will be going back to the power play. And Bolduc, no surprises, right back into it.
You know, Bolduc has been such a menace in this game. He's literally been the biggest villain to date in this hockey game. He's a guy that's getting so much under Bryce Swan's skin, so much under, looks like Brett Morrison's skin. He's doing a good job of it so far. But Bryce Swan, most of the games that we call, he's a guy that doesn't seem to be too well-liked around this league. That's just the way he plays, though. He's a gritty guy. He'll get in your face. He's big. He's physical. He'll take you right down, but he's also got skill to burn, too. So he's a tough guy to play against. Real special talent.
Lewis will be in the box for two or less here as Lacroix does a nice job keeping that puck in, fires it around, hits the ref. X-Men catch a break, and they're able to send the Aigle Bleu back into their own zone. Shots 59 favoring the X-Men, 11:25 remaining in the second period. Still awaiting this game's first goal.
There you go.
Pageau does a nice job breaking that puck out. Breaking that puck up, excuse me. Morrison will get the puck in with the Aigle Bleu controlled with Lacroix. Lacroix, stick handling, finds Ouellette on the side. He gets it through center to Quenel. Quenel back to Gruel at the line. Over to Lacroix, fakes the shot. Back over to Ouellette.
Watch that.
Ouellette on the boards. We'll be looking for that pass. Ouellette to Lacroix. That's Quenel. His shot from the line. Tipped in front and blocked there by Pageau. Nice play by him. The Aigle Bleu continuing to set up in the zone. This is Ouellette on the far boards, looking in front. Had a man open, but was broken up just at the last second. Ouellette controls again. Looking again for that pass. This time he finds Rochon. It's tipped wide. Ouellette. Back down to Quenel. One-timer to Lacroix. There it is, and a nice save there by Perricone. Back to Gruel at the line. Good pressure here from the Aigle Bleu. This is Ouellette on the far boards. 40 seconds remaining in the penalty to Lewis. Looking in front. There's a shot. They score! As he knew one of those was going to work, and it was Gruel who was able to put it past Perricone, and the Aigle Bleu lead 1-0.
Real frustrating. Really frustrating for St. Evex, I should say. There wasn't much they could do. That's why Moncton's ranked second in the league in the power play percentage, power play goals. We just saw how good they were there. So dangerous on the sideboards, Ouellette is. I mean, he's just a magician back there. He can just pick his poison. He doesn't matter. I mean, he's a real tough guy to cover. X keyed in too much on Lacroix, I think. Because they knew Lacroix had the big shot, which left Gruel wide open in the slot, and he was able to snap one short side on Perricone. You just can't be taking any more penalties. That just can't happen anymore. You just got to shake this off. Now, like I said earlier, They've lost 11 one-goal games, which is unheard of in this league.
Chance in front again, and a shot just wide. It might have been tipped there by Perricone, as he's just robbed Blanchard there, pardon me, if that's the case.
Well, yeah.
Aigle-Bleu with a big chance there. Yeah. That could have been very easily 2-0.
Huge. The veteran guys have to step up for St. Evex right now. Jason Bast, Bryce Swan, Brett Morrison, Spencer McAvoy, guys like that, they really have to set the tone here and lead the rest of the group.
Chisholm behind his net. Does a nice job getting away from his defender, Blanchard. Moving to center to Swan. Over to Bast. Bast to Swan.
Nice
a quick shot.
Shot
and a stop by Marion. A nice one, too. Bast in behind the net. Finds Kirkpatrick on the boards. Looking for a man in front. As Bass was taken down, no call. Here's O'Connor stepping in. O'Connor trying to get a shot away. Can't find. Still loose in front. Shot again, and it's tipped by an Aigle-Bleu defender and out of play. And a glorious chance there, as I believe that was Nick Pageot.
Yeah, you never.
In front.
That was Gabe O'Connor right there. And you never expect
Gabe
to see,
O'Connor.
You never expect
right.
to see Gabriel O'Connor that wide open in the slot there. That was just really unheard of for a guy like him. I mean, he's such a stay-at-home defensive type guy. Gabriel O'Connor so close in front, but real good response shift by St. Evex. It's exactly what they needed. They couldn't get complacent, sit back in their own end, get upset that they're down 1-0. They went right back at it, got right back on the saddle, and stretched right towards the...
You're absolutely right. It looks like the ruling here is that Gabe O'Connor shot out of play without a deflection, so the faceoff will come outside his zone. So obviously a shot that he cannot be happy with.
No.
Explaining a skyward look after that play. Remains 1-0 Aigle-Bleu. On a goal, power play goal by Gruel. O'Connor gets the center and will dump the puck in. Undershoot on the boards, finds Stevens in behind the net. Has Jodin working over him. Stevens runs into his own man and loses the puck. And Côté will move to center for the Aigle-Bleu. This is Rochon on the far on the close side. Rochon stops up, looking for teammates, finds Gay at the point. Gay back down in. Pass comes back to Gay. With room. Winds up. Shoots.
Nice block.
And fearlessly blocked by Gabe O'Connor. Gay continues on with the puck. There's a shot in front. And Perricone staying with it is able to cover up. A great block there from Gabe O'Connor as Gay had a lot of room to step into that shot.
Yeah, it looked like St. Evex lost a bit of their defensive assignments there. Gabe O'Connor, tremendous job on the block. Hit him right in the back. I'm surprised he's okay right now because he looks like he should be good to go. But St. Evex has to do a better job of getting bearing down on their sticks, winning these defensive battles. Moncton cannot, St. Evex cannot afford to go down 2-0 to a very strong Moncton team here.
This is Labrie at the point. He dumps the puck in. Poulin is there. Poulin looking for teammates. Puck coming to the front. There's a shot and a nice save by Perricone. Puck will come out to center. That was Pilon on the short side there with that quick shot. Shot 16-12 favoring the X-Men, but it's the Aigle-Bleu who lead 1-0. 8 minutes remaining in the second period. Rodrigue chips that puck to center where Lewis controls. Puck chipped in, and Labrie will take after it. He skates around his net. Quick outlet pass to Rodrigue, who moves through center. He dumps the puck in. Day chasing after it there with Pilon. A big collision there. Both seem to be okay, though. X moving the puck to center, tipped. And Bass looking for it there. Couldn't keep up with it, though. Kirkpatrick is this number one line for Cinefex. Comes back on again, looking for some offensive production. Swan looking at that puck in front. Taken away by Poulin.
Nice
who's catch. Taken to the hard boards. Taken to the boards hard there by Claffey with a nice hit.
Oh!
There was a big step up there. As Pilon was the victim there. On a nice hit. Physical play starts to pick up. Both teams making changes, though. As Kirkpatrick moves to center, making moves, and a nice one. He gets through center, looking for Bast on the boards. All Bast can do is dump it in where Bolduc and Kirkpatrick battle for it. Bolduc comes away with the puck, plays along the side. Swan cuts it off, though. In behind the net, Pageau will pinch in, and he will get there first. Swan takes the puck away from Ouellette. Feeds Pageau at the point. Pageau feeds to the other side. That's Claffey there dumping the puck in. Battling for it still along the boards. This will
That's
be Bolduc coming away with it. And Ouellette now through center. Ouellette throws that puck on net. Perricone's got it short side. And he's able to hang on to it for a whistle.
Yeah, good job by Perricone there. Or Moncton did see him. I mean, the next few shifts after X's great response, Moncton seemed to gain a bit more momentum after their first goal. They had X and Hemmed in their own zone for a little while there. So X survived a bit of the storm here, and let's hope the storm doesn't heat up for X's case.
Face off to the right of Perricone, won by the X-Men. Day pushes the puck over to Sims on the far side.
Oh,
his pass looking for DeVoe gets by him. The Aigle Bleu will dump the puck back in. Lewis chasing after it. Lewis, a nice play getting away from his forechecker. Sims at center. Put his teammate offside there by dumping that puck in late, so they'll have to tag up. Puck chipped to center when Day finds it. He can only push it ahead. And it'll be sent the length of the ice by the Aigle Bleu for an icing call. 5:52 remaining in the second period.
Line of Stevens, DeVoe, and Sims. That may have been their third shift of the game. They don't play a whole lot. But good job by them keeping things simple, dumping the puck in. That's the way they have to play if they're looking for more ice time. And they don't keep things too flashy. They keep it simple. That's all you ask for if you're the coach.
Brandon Stevens and undershoot now out for the X-Men. That puck shot way up in the crowd there. His head's up. As Gay shot that puck right out of play. And we'll have a face-off. And now Gay and looks like undershoot will be talking because over Brandon comes in as the bad blood continues here in this game.
Yeah, the chirps are towards the old field goal. Cundiff special from Baltimore right up in the right up in the rafters, a little wide right. So I don't know, they're giving it to him. Brandon and undershoot were giving it to Gay there. So
you're absolutely right, though, on the X-Men perspective. They need this next goal, as they cannot afford to go down 2 to a very strong Moncton team. The Aigle Bleu controls as Blanchard dumps the puck in. Fayou and Charlon will be in after it hard. McAvoy has trouble controlling it. Good job by the Aigle Bleu forecheckers. Stevens in there as well. McAvoy still battling for it. Is that Charlon who is down there? Puck eventually comes loose, and McAvoy will skate to center. His pass goes through Brandon's legs. Here's a chance here for the Aigle Bleu. There's a shot by Fay. That's stopped by Perricone. He swats the puck to the corner. Stevens bumps Charlon as they battle for it in the corner. Good job by Charlon. He comes away with the puck, though. Gives it away to Chisholm, who rings it hard along the boards. Not hard enough, though, as Gay keeps it at the line. Pardon me, that was Lacroix who walked the line there. Back and pass fed in front. Faye had a whack at it off the side of the net. Brandon intercepts that centering pass, and now the X-Men will move out. Undershoot by himself as teammates are making changes. Nice job. Stops up. Feeds looking for Kirkpatrick in front of the net. Cote just at the last second able to break it up. Here's a centering pass. Kirkpatrick again. This time couldn't control it. So looking for Kirkpatrick in front of that net for the equalizer. Kirkpatrick battling for it now on the half boards. Dumps the puck in where undershoot will keep after it. He goes outside the other, around the other side. Puck deflected off a stick high off the glass. Perrenton takes a run at Pageau. Swan finds Kirkpatrick. His shot stopped by Marion, hasn't had a shot in a while. This is O'Connor at the line. His shot put towards the net. Blocked there by the Aigle Bleu. And then will come away. It's Perrenton. Looking for Cote. That puck fired in on, or dumped in on Perrenton. Cote right there. And Perrenton will be forced to cover up. 3:38 remaining in the second period. The Aigle Bleu have caught up in shots now. Well, almost anyway. 17-15. They trail the X-Men. They do have that first goal. A power play goal earlier this period by Gruhl. And that's standing up so far, Jamie.
It is, but kudos to Moncton. They capitalized on their power play when St. Evex couldn't capitalize on their power play. So that's the difference special teams usually is in these types of games.
There's a poor clearing attempt there by Claffey. Lucky to get away with it, though, as it bounced over the Aigle Bleu defender stick. Here's a chance now for the Aigle Bleu. Perrenton coming in. Looking far side. There's a shot by Rochon as he just missed the close post. Boy, a close call there. As an odd man rush, almost. Here's a chance. Cote turns it over. There's a shot off the post. It's a horrible giveover by the X-Men. Again, results And Cote putting it off the post. Another glorious chance. Cote has it on the boards. Looks for Rochon. Rochon does a nice job fighting off Day. He still has the puck. Centers in front. Perricone down. Makes the save. Claffey puts the puck to the boards. X-Men on their heels here. This is Poulin around behind the net. Fighting off Reyes' defender. Poulin steals the puck in and besides. That's Rochon trying to cover up. Blocked by Claffey. Puck still loose in front, and Rochon just put it wide. Cote battling for it. And now Claffey will have a bit of time as this X-Men unit has to be tired. Moving the puck to center. Morrison looking for it there. The long change, though. X will have a hard time changing. A few forwards will. But Claffey and Day turn over. There's a turnover there. Nice play by Claffey to break that pass up. This is Jodin at the line. He has room. His shot towards the net. Blocked there. Is about three absolutely horrendous giveaways there by the X-Men. And they are fortunate not to be down. Another goal. The Aigle Bleu moving to center, but Rodrigue can't handle his pass. Gay steps into his man, Sims. Here's a chance for Stevens. Coming towards the net, Brandon is there as well. They couldn't handle it. Here's Gay to center. He drops for Rodrigue. Back over to Gay. Gay drops for Pilon. Quillon, big man, making moves incoming wide. Centers the puck loose in front and poked away there by the X-Men, and they'll break out. This is Brandon. Brandon puts towards the net, Bass, and they're stopped by Marion as that puck ricocheted back towards the net. A breakaway pass. Nice play by Kirkpatrick, as that would have been Ouellette in all by himself. And Ouellette attempting to dump the puck in will put it out of play. And boy, some glorious chances for the Aigle Bleu.
Could have been an absolute game changer right there. Michael Kirkpatrick with a phenomenal defensive play to get a stick in the passing lane. Dean Ouellette was off to the races. He had all day. He could have had an order at Pizza Hut too and would have had stuffed crust. As was he going to go top cheese on Perricone? Who knows? But that was an excellent job by Kirkpatrick to break that up, or else that could have been, the game could have been wide open now.
Absolutely. A very, very heads-up play there by the forward, Michael Kirkpatrick. But that line of Day and Claffey responsible there for a few turnovers as they were tired with that long change in that second period. Aigle Bleu called for icing here. 1:09 remaining in the second period.
It's the fast period. There wasn't a whole lot of whistles. Problem with Stanovex for the most of the year, and I can't get it through my skull. They have great starts. Their first period is usually very good. They usually win the first period. Second period has not been that strong for the Blue and White. Moncton was able to get back in this game. Third period, they usually come out strong. If this period ends up being their downfall, there's going to be a lot of questions that have to be answered.
That's right. Second period's never a strong point from the X-Men, as they're outscored, I believe. We'll have to check this, but I believe by 15 goals throughout this season. We'll check that stat again, but second period's not strong for the X-Men. Down 1-0 here, though, as Bass slips and falls, though, as he tried to turn on a dime. Puck kept in momentarily, but it'll be the Aigle Bleu making the center. Here's Ouellette coming in on the left wing. Nice play by Lewis to try and break it up. Coming around the net, Ouellette still with it. Comes out the other side. Finds Labrie. Shoots, and a nice save by Perico as he came out to challenge. Kirkpatrick, a nice play to dive and break that play up. Chance in front,
wow,
a nice blocker
save
by Perricone. Puck loose at the side of the net. There's a centering pass, and it looked like Swan might have put that puck back towards his net. Perricone very alertly, though, is able to get the pen out. 5 seconds remaining in the second period. Ouellette behind his net, looking for the far side, and that pass broken up there by Bass. And the second period will come to an end at the great relief of the X-Men that they are not down more. And some glorious chances there. Perricone had to be very sharp.
Huge relief. I mean, that Perricone, they all need to give Perricone a tap on the pads as soon as he gets in that dressing room. That was a phenomenal job by Joey Perricone the last 2 minutes. He showed his tough metal. He showed his tough composure, and he kept his team in that one. Going forward, we're done 40 minutes. Shots are 19-17 for St. Evex. Moncton clearly had that period in the bag. They were all over the X-Men. St. Evex cannot take penalties. They need to be a penalty-free team this third period. They need to let Joey Perricone see the puck, and they need to control the time of the attack. They need to control the puck possession in the offensive zone going forward.
You're absolutely right there. That would have absolutely been a backbreaker, for the X-Men if the Aigle Bleu were able to bury one there. So, as we stand 1-0, the University of Moncton Aigle Bleu lead the St. Francis Xavier X-Men. Quick scoring summary here. There's one goal in that period, a power play goal at 9:40 by Gru. The assists go to Quaynell and Ouellette. as the Aigle-Bleu 1-for-4 on the power play, X 0-for-3 on the power play. It's two very good power plays in this league. The Aigle-Bleu winning in that department so far. As we will step out here, and actually before we do, will we have a chance for a second period interview?
I don't believe so. I believe that St. Evex will want their players in the dressing room for the next period, so I'm sorry, guys, we're not going to be able to get you one. If they were winning after two periods, it could have been a different story, but they're down 1-0, so they're going to be in the room all focused.
Sounds good. As we will be back for the third period in, I'd say, about 10 or so minutes. Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, to the Keating Center here in Anaganish. 1-0 the Aigle Bleu lead over the X-Men on a power play goal by Gruel in that second period. All set for the third here between these two teams. And Matt Cullen here with Jamie Kelly. And Jamie, the X-Men need a big period here to get themselves back in this game. Next goal, huge.
That's an astronomical understatement right there. The big period, that's, I mean, for one, Dalhousie right now is in UPEI, and they are currently winning 2-0 after two periods. St. of X loses this game. Dalhousie wins their game. St. of X is out of the last playoff spot into seventh place. Dalhousie moves into that spot. This period is the biggest period of their season so far.
And it begins here as the Aigle Bleu go offside.
And there's lots of time. I mean, St. of X has the firepower easily. So much firepower to get back in this game. They just got to utilize their scoring chances, get shots on net, get traffic in front of Marion. He's a very good goaltender who, could, when he sees the shot, he's most likely going to save it unless he got a seeing eye shot.
You're absolutely right. Marion playing very well for the Aigle Bleu here, stopping all 19 shots thrown his way. Perricone, though, no slouch either for the X-Men as he has stopped 16 of 17 and some of them being very difficult shots, particularly in the late stages of that second period. Puck in the Aigle Bleu zone here, controlled by University of Moncton, and they will get it to center and fire it in. As Bergeron takes it, he's hit hard by Claffey, and the puck comes free to Ray. Ray makes a nice move, and he'll start out. Finds Claffey, who finds Morrison in the middle. Morrison to the far side, shot there, and a quick one by Struthers, and a quick glove save there by Marion as he'll cover up.
Yeah, nice shot there. And we're seeing a different dimension to Claffey's game that we haven't in a long time. He's been very physical. He's not the biggest guy. He'd probably be about 5'11", 185, compared to the bigger Moncton forwards. But he's done a really good job of shutting them down, bringing them to the ice, and closing down shooting lanes. So he's been really solid.
Pazzo was shot from the line, blocked. And here comes Rochon on the right wing. His shot stopped by Perricone. Rebound in front, stopped again. Puck behind the net. As a tough luck there for the Aigle Bleu. Rochon had his stick break as he was coming around for a wraparound there. This is Stevens to center for the X-Men. He moves in, stops up, looks for trailers, can't find it though. His stick got tangled up there. Puck shoveled towards that, easily blocked there by the Aigle Bleu. And Rochon now with a new stick will chip the puck in and he'll head it off. Chisholm controls in his own zone for the X-Men. He has time to move out. Chisholm finds undershoot on the left wing, he gets it into the zone. Puck goes past Stevens' zone, outside the zone. And Blanchard for the Aigle Bleu will take it. His shot, a blocker save by Perricone, and a nice one too. Faye keeps it in, his long shot. Deflected in front, and that's stopped again by Perricone. The Aigle Bleu putting everything on net here in the early going. That stick causing problems, the broken one on the end boards. The X-Men do come away with it though.
Oh.
And a tough call there. Swan looking for Bast. Bast just a step ahead of the play there, though. And then we'll be called on an offside, and we'll have a faceoff just outside the University of Moncton zone.
Yeah, a little tough there. Bast a little ahead of his jump there. Just offside. That would have been a huge two-on-one there for St. of X. Back to the drawing board, though. Faceoff in their right outside their blue line.
That's right. As it was a pass, the faceoff will come right outside the X-Men zone as they'll finally get the broken stick cleaned up there. Shots down 19-19. See Aigle Bleu with a couple quick shots here in the early going of this third period. Just over 2 minutes into this third period. Bass chipping that puck in. Fitzpatrick will go after it. Swan there too. Swan can't handle a puck on the end boards though, and the Aigle Bleu will break out with Blanchard. Blanchard three, Aigle Bleu to
big
center.
Hit.
And a big hit there by Mark Lewis as he stepped into Blanchard. Puck centered in front, cut off there. And the X-Men will move through center.
Oh,
and Kirkpatrick on that left side a little bit too anxious as he was ahead of that one step ahead there. And a tough break for the X-Men. That's twice they've been offside there in that last minute.
Yeah, you know, that's real frustrating without a doubt for that. Mark Lewis just made an absolute massive hit there. I mean, he's a guy. I've been so impressed with Mark Lewis this season on St. of X's blue line. He, to me, is their best defenseman. He's always in the offensive rush. He has a great shot, real good skater for his size, and he's exceptionally physical. He's a guy, in my opinion, has a chance to go pro.
As you said there, Lewis, a big hit, making his presence felt, and has played very well in this game and this season. The X-Men will need something, though. They'll need more than physical play to get themselves back in this game. They trail 1-0. The Aigle Bleu cycling in his own zone, but Struthers will come away with it on the far side. Struthers with Morrison in the center. He finds him. Morrison in, turns and shoots, and a nice save there by Marion as Morrison was unceremoniously dumped. Gets back on his feet, though. Puck comes out to center. Pageau dumps the puck back in. St. FX completing a change, though, so the Aigle Bleu will have time, and they'll headman it quickly. Ouellette takes a hit there as he dumps the puck in from Brandon. Pageau, dangerous pass through center, gets through to Brandon, though, and he'll dump it in. The Aigle Bleu control, nice passing quickly as they move up. Rochon now. Rochon will get the puck deep, and Côté will be in after it. McAvoy battling there with Côté. McAvoy does a nice job pushing the puck ahead to undershoot, who goes far side to Pageau. Had trouble controlling the pass, slips and falls. The X-Men still controlling. Stevens pressured by Perrantou. This is Pageau takes control. He finds Brandon. Brandon in on the left wing. Brandon stops up, has the puck on the half boards, that was Chisholm there, the trailer. Puck didn't get through, though, and it's all the way back in the X-Men zone. 15:35 remaining in the third period. 1-0, the Aigle Bleu lead in a very tight checking third period so far. This is Kirkpatrick finding Bast in the middle. Puck hopping on him, so all he can do is dump the puck in. Marion, as he does so well, out to stop the puck for Bolduc. Bolduc pushes the puck ahead to Rochon, and he'll chip it out. Chisholm takes it there. Chisholm tangled up with Poulin. Bass gets the puck, though, as his pass doesn't get through. The Aigle Bleu doing a very good job preventing the X-Men from entering the zone. X will dump it in. Marion is there, sweeps it around for Poulin, who chips it ahead. The Aigle Bleu break out with three. Is that puck dumped in there by Grew? Puck centered in front. Here's Fyatt. His shot fanned on it. Back to Lacroix. Wines fakes the shot. Looking down inside. And a nice save by Perricone as he was sliding to his right to make that save. Morrison tangled up with two Aigle Bleu players there. Lacroix gets the puck in his zone. That was a good play from Lacroix to fake that shot there to look down low. This is Claffey at the point. His shot deflected. And it'll go up into the netting and out of play. And we'll have a stoppage.
I'm really surprised that last sequence there for Moncton, that Lacroix didn't just let it boom. I mean, he's got one of the hardest shots in this league, if not the hardest. And, I mean, he had a clear shooting lane. No traffic in front. That's probably why he didn't let it go. I mean, because he knew maybe Perricone would be up to the task. Instead, he opted for the pass, which Perricone was actually up to the task there as well. So, good job by Perricone, and could be a lucky break for X.
Undershoot looking in front. That puck right on the post there. Dangerously in front. Swept away quickly, though, by Lacroix. Undershoot takes it down the boards. Has trouble handling, though. Stevens finds it in the middle. Aigle Bleu defenders all around him, though, and they take the puck away. Puck loose on the half boards and chipped to center. Stevens will get it back, though, as the X-Men really having a hard time gaining the zone because the Aigle Bleu really trapping up the system here a little bit, making it hard for the X to see it. To skate in, so when they opt to dump the puck in, Marion is there to set it up, play the puck out, and that's the one of the advantages of having a very good puck-moving goaltender, and the X-Men are seeing that firsthand right now. Puck sent out again by the Aigle Bleu. Brandon takes a bump and turns it over. This is Ouellette coming through. Ouellette shoots the puck and it hit it, and it's tipped off a stick there and out of play. 13-12 remaining in this third period, 20-20, and Jamie, the X-Men having a tough time getting some shots through.
No, you're bang on there. Moncton has utilized the trap in this third period. They're not pressuring St. Evex defense. They're waiting for X to join the rush to enter the neutral zone, and they shut it right down, and he hit another good point. Marion is doing a great job of playing the puck, so when St. Evex has the opportunity to dump the puck in, Marion is breaking up the passing lanes. That X is not able to gain any momentum.
Here's Bass looking in the center, and a nice play there to break that puck up. The Aigle Bleu, lots of busy sticks, blocking off a lot of passing lanes here for X. Just like there, as Côté will turn the puck over, cause a turnover. He comes in, tries to make a move around McAvoy. Doesn't work, though. Puck in deep center in front for Rochon and missed him and goes all the way down the length of the ice. No call, though, as it was sent down by the Aigle Bleu. Gruel in his own zone. Moving the puck ahead to Côté, who comes in with speed. Côté works around. Chisholm tips that puck behind the net. Perrontot is there. Perrontot still battling for it. Finds the shot. That was Jodin with a quick shot there and a nice save by Perrucconi. Is that puck just dribbles? That puck just dribbled wide. Pardon me. Close call there. Puck sent back in. Perrucconi tries to stop it. Chisholm gets the puck first. Ray moving to center now. Finding Day on the far side. Chisholm there as well. Pressured. He'll send it back. And the X-Men will try again. They will dump the puck in. Marion can't handle it this time, and Morrison was trying to get in there. Broken up nicely, though, by Jodin. Gay moving the puck up to Blanchard, and he chips it out. Lewis intercepts and sends the puck in hard around. St. FX making a change, though, so Struthers is late getting in on the forecheck and the Aigle Bleu control. The Aigle Bleu now get to center with Gay, who dumps the puck in. Lewis can't control it, though. Blanchard almost had a chance down at the side of the net. An undershoot will take it for X, and he'll pass it to Brandon, who comes in. Brandon along the far side. Nice job there by the Aigle Bleu defender to break it up. Undershoot gloved the puck forward to himself, although he reached back, causing the play to be offside. Puck through center. Undershoot having trouble with it. Is the Aigle Bleu doing a really good job clogging up the neutral zone? This is Lacroix from his own zone. Ouellette tips that puck in. O'Connor will take it there. Approaching the halfway mark of this third period. 1-0 Aigle Bleu lead. This is Bergeron, finds Ouellette on the far side. Ouellette stops up. Looking for Bergeron, he lets it go. Far side chance, and a shot in front, and a nice save by Perrucconi. That might have hit his own defender's stick. He was able to get across, though. Claffey in, takes a bump, centers the puck there. Swan can't handle it. Puck chipped around there. O'Connor will hustle, and he will keep it in. O'Connor fakes the shot. Nice pack into Kirkpatrick. Makes the move. Lost the puck, though, in doing so. And Ouellette will take the puck, chips it forward, and the Aigle Bleu will get the puck out. This is Bass trying with speed. He'll try and work his way in. That doesn't work. And broken up quickly. Swan battling for it on the far side. Perrontot will take it. And the Aigle Bleu clinging to this one goal lead here. 9:30 remaining in the third period. Chisholm cuts that puck off there. The puck ends up in the Aigle Bleu zone and will be quickly moved forward by Bolduc, who takes a hit from Ray. McAvoy turns quickly, looking for Struthers, who gets the puck out. Good pressure there by the Aigle Bleu. X just cannot find any way through. McAvoy will try it. His puck broken up there. As he bumps Rochon, McAvoy will get the puck back. All he can do is send it back in, where Jodin will take it. This is Gay from his own end. Looks into the middle and finds Poulin. Côté dumps the puck in softly. Poulin comes in after it. Collides with Ray. And that's Rochon there as well. He comes away with it. Makes a nice move. Shoots. Nice save by Perrucconi. Rebounded. That's stopped as well. And he kicks it out for a third save. Puck still loose. And that puck off the post. Rochon there. Some glorious chances for the Aigle Bleu. Perrucconi, though, standing tall, keeping his team in the game. And now we'll have a penalty being called. And it'll be on the X-Men here for a high stick. And that is not what they need at this moment.
This is, there's not a whole lot what you can say. I mean, it's been a really bad period for St. FX. They have one shot through 12 minutes of play. There's not enough urgency right now. The only one urgent on the St. FX squad right now is Coach Brad Peddle, who's right down there giving it to the referee. Thinks there should have been another penalty on one of their players. I'm a little shocked, though, at St. FX right now. Their veteran guys have to show more urgency. They have to show more jam. You really have to get into the dirty areas. Yes, they're clogging the they're clogging the neutral zone with the trap. There's ways around that, and they have to be able to utilize it. It's tough right now for St. Evax.
You're absolutely right. As they'll look to kill off the UDM power play, which almost strikes quickly there as Dean Ouellette just sent that puck high. Ouellette finding the puck on the half boards. Now he'll set it up. Ouellette still controlling. Shot towards the net there. A good stick from O'Connor. That puck deflected out of play. But Jamie, like you were saying, I completely agree. X has been very flat. They've come out of the gate very flat this period. But give credit to where it's due. Yeah. The Aigle Bleu have really done a nice job of really shutting everything down pretty much. But like you said, there are other ways around it. They need to find those, and they need to find them fast. And a way to start would be to kill off this penalty here.
Totally. And they're a very well-coached team, and clearly they have a good defensive system in place, and they're really sticking to it right now.
A pass in the front, and a great save by Berger. Rebound, they score! As that was Lacroix, I think, in front. Pardon me, Rochon. It was Rochon who banged it in there, but a brilliant save by Perricone, moving across to his right. Nothing he could do on the rebound, though, as it found itself right in the middle, and Rochon was there, and he was able to bang it in.
And, you know, Joey Perricone is in no way at fault here. He's absolutely had a tremendous game. He's letting two goals. He has 25 saves out of 27 shots. A lot of saves, highlight reel. He's the reason that St. Evex is even remotely in this after their lackluster third so far in the second period.
That's right. And a big goal there for the Aigle Bleu by Rochon. There's a shot there from undershoot, stop there. Pageau will try again. That shot again, stopped by Marion. There's now another thing for X to worry about here. Is if they do get that puck to the net, they have still Marion to beat. A very solid goaltender. Is an uphill battle here. 7.5 minutes
remaining.
A big hit there by McAvoy as he took out Fay. Stevens dumps the puck in, and X will get it to the forecheck. Undershoot controlling behind the net. Finds Brandon. Brandon takes advantage of his defender not having a stick. Fay gets a stick back, though. Undershoot in behind the net, looking in front. His pass goes astray, and the Aigle Bleu will break out to center. This is Lacroix in. Lacroix drops for Fay. Fay around the net, centering in front, and it hit a skate. Chisholm controls for X. Chisholm will start out through center. St. FX completing a change, though, so he lacking some teammates. Takes a big hit there from Blanchard. Goes down, pops right back up, though. Puck sent out through the net, in front of the net. Chisholm, a long shot, steered away easily by Marion. Kirkpatrick in behind the net. Kirkpatrick taken down, no call. Finds Swan, though. Back in behind the net for Kirkpatrick. Kirkpatrick comes out. Looks at the point to Clavy. His shot, though, will be easily stopped by Marion as there is no traffic in front, and he'll hang on.
Yeah, good pressure there by St. Evex coming back after the second goal. I mean, you have to think, though, is it too little too late? I mean, they're down 2-0, 6 minutes to go. By no means is this period over. It's just very frustrating.
And if you look to X here, they have got to be wondered where the goals have gone, obviously being shut out last game against Acadia, 1-0. Here down 2-0, approaching two full games where they haven't scored a goal. There's a quick shot from the point, though, going wide. X showing some life here, though, as Ray battling for it on the boards. Has the stick chopped out of his hand by Bolduc, and X will go to the power play here, and maybe that's the thing they'll need to give them some life.
Well, they have to score on this power play. I mean, it's not an if, it's not a maybe, it's an absolute guarantee, it's a must. They need to score on this power play here. 6 minutes to go in the game, down 2-0. They need a power play goal here, and maybe a last-minute miracle. But, I mean, it's just, where do you go? I mean, you hit it right in the head. With all the firepower on their team, it's absolutely shocking and dumbfounding how they are not able to score. They have a tough time putting the puck in the net, and with so many offensive weapons, it's maddening.
Here's a chance here for Ouellette coming in short side. Perricone holds the post, though, and makes that save. Bass will start out for X. Bass finds Struthers in the middle, puts it for Brandon on the far side. Brandon controls, and X will set up. Back in deep there for Struthers. His centering pass knocked away, and Ouellette controls. He'll pass to Fay. Fay makes a few moves, and he'll send the puck softly into the X zone. 5:22 now remaining in this third period. McAvoy to Struthers. Struthers dumps the puck in for the to the opposite corner to Swan. Swan around to Struthers, who lets it go to Kirkpatrick. X looking to set up here, haven't done it yet. Kirkpatrick on the end boards, now they will. Back to McAvoy. He winds, fakes. Over on the far side, this is Bass. Down low, Struthers. Back to Bass. Now has a hard time handling that pass, and that hurts as X had a good system set up there. Puck sent along the boards. Kirkpatrick can't keep it in. And McAvoy will control at his own line. To Kirkpatrick. Over to Bast. Bast chips the puck in. Struthers will chase it. 40 seconds remaining in the penalty to Bull Duke. Swan on the half boards. He has it back up to Kirkpatrick. Back over to Day. Day into Bast. Bast controls the ring line. He'll cut in. His shot blocked there. Might have hit Swan. Swan leaves for Struthers. Back out to Bast. Finding Day at the point. Day moves to the center. His shot blocked there. There's a shot again. And Bass fans on it. That puck hit a rough sequence again there for St. FX. That shot by Day hit an X-planner in front and then followed up quickly there by a fan. Bolduc steps out of the box as teams are back to 5-on-5. X 0 for 4 on the power play. 3:53. There's a shot. They score. Yeah. It looked like Undershoot might have got it in front. And just as soon as the power play was over, the X-Men strike, and they're back in the game.
Well, you hit it in the head there. 0 for 4 in the power play. Artie Chisholm, local boy, coming down with the great speed on this half wall. He's got one of the best first steps I've seen in this league. Tremendous job coming through, beating his defender. All he did was throw it on net from the back of the net. That's all you have to do. A goaltender like Marriott, he's so good that you can't be looking to pick corners. You just got to throw it. Just throw it. Hope for traffic and hope for a bounce. Thankfully, they got the first hockey god bounce of their career, sorry. And this is massive. I mean, that was a huge goal.
That was a big goal. As it looked like all hope might have been lost there as Bull Duke just stepped out of the box. But like you said, puck was thrown in front of the net off a skate and finds the back of the net. There's a turnover there. Here's Ouellette. Coming in, looking the far side. In front again, looking for Bergeron. Puck swiped away, though. Bass staying out there as he's been out for a while now. He'll move to center. 3:20 to go in the third period. The X-Men with that last goal there, making it 2-1.
Yeah, they were able to bear. Okay, yeah, good job by Undershoot just driving the net there, and Artie Chisholm was able to throw it on net. Great job. You can bet that Brad Pettle will be playing his key offensive guys for the next 3:18 of this period. Undershoot will be there for sure. Morrison, Bast, Brandon, Swan, Kirkpatrick.
Here's a shot from the line from Chisholm. Puck just going in wide. Day pinching in, able to keep it in for Undershoot. Puck on the end boards there, Brandon. Three, Aigle Bleu there. Puck still loose. Puck sent towards the net there. Morrison looking to come away with it. Chisholm does a nice job keeping it in. Makes a nice move around his defender. Chisholm to the net. Shot! Oh. And a nice save by Marion as he just got a toe on it. Great moves there. And a close call. Chisholm almost turns the puck over. Gets away with it though. Brandon dumps the puck in. Undershoot will carry in after it. Quick play there to reverse it behind the net. And the Aigle Bleu will move out. Faye to center. Moves to the opposite wing. They're on a change though. No winger there. Pageot for the X-Men controls back to McAvoy. 2:25 now remaining in this game. 2-1 Aigle Bleu lead. Pageot moves to center for X. Pazzo, he'll shoot towards the net. Comes loose. And a close call there as Bryce Swan almost had an open net. Couldn't control the puck though. That puck will be dropped and it'll come outside the line for an offside call. And boy, another hockey bounce there. Almost worked for the X-Men.
Yeah, they almost got another bounce there. Bryce Swan had a glorious chance, but the puck just seems to bounce on him too much there. Artie Chisholm again, excellent job on the blue line. Made a phenomenal play to get around one offensive player. And then he just made a great play, just getting a nice shot on that Marion. Almost solved him. Real good job, and Chisholm's getting rewarded with ice time right now. And why not? I mean, he's an offensive guy from the back end, can clearly put the puck in the back of the net, keep him out there.
That's right. A great save there from Marion as he was able to just get his toe on it there, preserving the one-goal lead. Chisholm dumps the puck in, and he'll carry in after with steam. Puts a hit on Bull Duke in the corner. Bull Duke comes away with the puck, though. Finds Rochon, who is able to move it as far as the line, where Bass keeps in. Bass puts it on the net. Blocker to the corner. Blast tries a shot. Didn't quite work out there. Rochon gets it to center and will dump the puck in. Carries in after it. Perricone moves around the net. 1:30 now remaining. As we'll keep our eye on Perricone. This is Bass moving out of his own zone to center. Bass to the far side to McAvoy. Puts the puck in front. Back to Bass. Bass, who's hit hard, falls awkwardly in the board. Swan takes the puck. Perricone working his way out of the net. He's gone to the bench. There's a shot in front. A nice play by Lacroix there as he blocked that shot. St. FX pressuring here, though, as we move into the last minute of play. Perricone at the bench, 6-on-5 here. Puck back to the point to Pageau. And on the boards, Brandon tries a shot. That's blocked. They better be careful as that net is empty. Pageau dumps the puck in. They're offside, though. Need to tag up. 45 seconds remain. The Aigle Bleu control in their own zone. Puck chipped to center. And chipped forward by Quenel. McAvoy with 35 seconds to go. McAvoy starts out. Finds Struthers on the far side. He'll chip it in. Undershoot. Going in hard after it. Gruel there. Puck centered towards the net. Knocked in behind though. Morrison hustling in after it. And the Aigle Bleu will be able to move the puck into center. 10 seconds remaining. As the X-Men are offside here. The Aigle Bleu will control. 5 seconds remaining. Puck chipped to center. And that'll pretty much do it. As time expires and the Aigle Bleu hang on, thanks to a power play goal by Rochon that gave them that 2-0 lead. The X-Men responded with a late goal, but it was too little too late, as a crushing loss there for the X-Men, who started out so well, Jamie, in that first period, outshooting them, the Aigle Bleu, at 7-1 at one point. But they weren't able to put him past Marion, and that was the end. And that tells the story right there.
And you watch Brad paddle right now on the St. FX bench, giving it to the referees. He thought there should have been an icing call there, which I almost agree with him. Referee was a little late in his whistle. There should be 2 extra seconds on the clock. It looks like that's the way it's going to be, though. Absolute dagger in the heart. There's nothing more that he can say than this has been the weirdest hockey season of all time for St. FX. They have such good talent on paper, but it really has not translated to the ice. That's their 12th one-goal game that they've lost. And it's just, it's out of hand. And I feel for the players, I feel for the coaching staff. It's really tough.
That's right. Shots at the end of the game, they're 27-27 equal. But of course, the Aigle Bleu winning 2-0. But if you're the X-Men, you can't get obviously a tough loss here, but they can't get two downers. They need to be ready to go for tomorrow, as the St. Thomas Tommies will be coming into town, and that is a must-win. We talked about this weekend, a big one for X. They're obviously not going to win the two games. To get the split, though, at least we'll keep them in the loop, but we'll see how the Dalhousie game turns out. But that sixth place in jeopardy, that last final playoff spot in jeopardy for the X-Men, as Dalhousie was winning earlier. Let's get to a quick summary here. Power play goal by Rochon from Lacroix and Quenel. They're in that third period. The X-Men do respond, though. Undershoot from Chisholm and Day at 16:09. But that's as close as they would come in this one, as they lose a heartbreaker 2-1.
Yeah, very, very tough game for the St. FX X-Men. Life's all about being optimistic, and that translates to sports, too. So just got to keep your head up. Move forward, look past it, get to the next one. Tomorrow night, no better way than facing off against the Tommies and setting up for a big one.
You're absolutely right. Hope you enjoyed the game, folks. Thanks very much, and we'll see you tomorrow night, 7 p.m. Atlantic start. St. FX will play the St. Thomas Tommies, and they will look to rebound. But as the Aigle Bleu win tonight, 2-1. And so long from Anna Ganish.